I did not see you guys there. Welcome to MTV Cribs. This is my crib, and welcome to my $1 million mansion in Beverly Hills. I'm just kidding, I'm renting an apartment in Silver Lake. This is my first apartment. Tour. I moved to Los Angeles this summer and I live in a house, but this house is divided into separate apartments, so it's kind of an apartment and kind of a house. It's a strange kind of mix. I feel like every single room has its own personality, kind of like I have 500 different personalities living inside me. Hashtag Gemini. Shall we go take a look at my house in Los Angeles? My first year living in Los Angeles, my first year living completely on my own. To be honest, 99.9% of the time, this house is a complete wreck, but it took me 4 days to clean this house. 4 days. That's how much I love you. Actually, this is a good thing. This is probably discipline for me. I should film more often. Anyway, let's get started. I have these two chairs that I bought from Blue Dot. They're super cool, and I cut up these little rugs to make them a little bit comfortable, so those are kind of my cushions. It's a very small place where I like to eat breakfast. I like to work on my computer here in the morning, and I have my keyboard here and my little machine, which is kind of like a DJ, not a DJ, but like a sound producing little machine. Oh, I forgot to show you guys this. This actually came in the mail yesterday. It's a huge little, okay, it's not a huge little, it's okay, ow. It is basically something that YouTube sent to me. They send it to everybody that pretty much reaches 1 million subscribers. It says, congratulations, Sonya Esman, on reaching 1 million subscribers. I have 1 million subscribers on my Russian YouTube channel, and this is the coolest, heaviest thing I have ever received in my entire life. And over here, I just keep basically my house keys, a bunch of sunglasses, this little framed photo that my friend actually thinks looks like, guess what it looks like? Leave it in the comments below if you can imagine something dirty that it would look like. I think it looks like a freaking gemstone. My friend thinks otherwise. I keep my favorite Chanel bag here. And basically just different random things like a pound weight. Let's move on to my kitchen. So this is my kitchen. I always like to keep fresh flowers in the house, and I buy myself flowers. I'm one of those girls. Basically, if you may have also noticed, a lot of my house is white. If I would have chosen and redesigned this house, I would have made the floors white. I like everything white because white makes the illusion of a larger space, a more open, airy, light space. And I wish my house was filled with sunlight. I am obsessed with sunlight. I have a sun tattoo. But unfortunately, this place doesn't get that much sun in the wintertime, and it's winter right now. So everything is pretty much white in this room, just to create the illusion of more light. So I keep my keyboard here. There's not much in this kitchen because it's a very small kitchen, and I don't really mind because I don't really cook a lot of the time. I used to be a raw vegan, so I kind of still stick to the principle of uncooking foods. So pretty much just taking things that are raw or eating things in their raw form, in their prepared organic form. I don't necessarily like to stare and make a concoction for like 5 hours. Because here I have a Marshall speaker actually. Marshall speakers are amazing. The quality and the bass on them is just incredible. So if I have to recommend a speaker for you, get the Marshall speaker. It's just literally phenomenal. So this is my living room. This couch is actually the first thing that I ever purchased for this apartment. It's from CB2. This table actually is an obsession of mine. It's from a site called High Fashion Home, and I hunted after this table for a long time. Again, I wanted something that was raw and organic, and this is pretty much like a lava rock inspired table, but the covering is stainless steel. So this gallery is actually from Tapan Collective. It's an online site, and they basically carry a lot of different original artists' artworks. They're all actually prints. They're photography prints, and they're limited edition, and I feel incredibly, incredibly lucky to have them. They're super high quality, and they're amazing because they just support different artists. You guys check out their site. I'll leave the link below. I essentially wanted a Tumblr feed on my living room wall. And this is cool because it kind of, you can kind of build your own gallery. So I have Frida here, I have a girl naked by a lake, birds and palm tree and an airplane and waves. It's all very free-spirited and liberal and kind of airy at the same time. I have these little furry pillows here, and these are actually super cool pillows that are from Jonathan Adler. This one says opium, and this one says LSD. This is a canister also from Jonathan Adler. Jonathan Adler is like the coolest place ever to buy your furniture. They're super expensive, but they're freaking amazing. This one says ganja. I don't smoke weed, I don't like weed, but I just think that's super funny. Oh my god, guess what I keep in my ganja canister? Nail polish. I'm so badass. Just call the cops.
This little seed is actually a prized possession of mine. Mostly because I never sit in it because it's kind of unpractical. It's mostly a decor thing. But I wanted a chair like this for the longest time, and I just think it's a very eclectic piece that'll move into any kind of decor in any house that I have in the future, because it's just so cool that it never kind of goes out of style. This is an electronic fireplace, actually, and it has sun fuel in it. I don't exactly know how to light this fireplace, but this place gets really cold in the wintertime, believe it or not. It gets colder than it is outside. If it's like 50 degrees outside, it's like 30 in here. And this is a cool little framed photo, one of my favorite quotes that says, "The world is your oyster." Quotes have seriously impacted my life in a very positive way. If I could, I would literally hang quotes up everywhere. So let's go to my closet. So welcome to my closet room. This is where I keep pretty much all of my clothing. This is where I keep all of my shoes, all of my bags, and I have two little racks here. One of them is of clothing that I have not worn yet. If I don't know what to wear in the morning, I can pretty much go to this rack. And I have this second rack right here, which is full of clothing that are my absolute favorites, like my favorite like leather vests and stuff. Things that I can throw on that I know I will love. So if you may have noticed, I love black boots. If I could have 1,000 pair of black boots, I would. If I could have all of these racks filled with black boots, I would. Also one of my favorite pairs of boots ever, but I've never worn them in my life. They're from Laurence Decod, and they're an absolute work of art, but I just don't know what to wear them with. And this is where I do all my makeup. I have an acrylic chair here, actually. This is just a plain acrylic chair, and I put a black sheepskin rug on top of it. So it just makes it more comfortable. And over here, I just have all of my clothing that pretty much is like collectible, if you shall say. All of my clothing kind of color coordinated. And at the bottom there, I have like jeans, jean shorts, sweaters, and stuff like that. And that's pretty much my closet room. This is where I get ready in the morning. Now I will show you guys my bedroom. My bedroom is a weird place because this place is not ultra decorated. I honestly didn't really know what to do with this place. And when I moved in on my own, I kind of made a rule that my bedroom is a place where I sleep. It's not a place where I eat. It's not a place where I do work. It's a place where I go to relax, pretty much. So this is actually one of my favorite pieces in my room. This is a little cork board where you can change the message. And this is one of my favorite quotes from a Weeknd song. The Weeknd is my favorite artist, by the way. And it says, "The world will be yours for the taking. The story you birth will be ages. Just learn to love pain and be patient." I get a lot of questions about this bed frame as well. This is a bed frame from Anthropologie. It was expensive, and to be honest, if I could redo this room, I would sleep on the floor. I love sleeping on the floor. Okay, so now let me take you to my favorite room, my bathroom. Now you might be thinking, Sonya, why is your favorite room your bathroom? Well, some people love kitchens, some people have a dream kitchen. I have a dream bathroom. I spend a lot of time in the bathroom, and not for reasons that you think. I love bathtubs, I love taking baths, I love sitting in warm water. There's nothing on this earth I like more than hot water. Just sitting in it and like pruning up in it, because it's like getting a hug. If something goes wrong in my day, if I start having panic, I get in the bathtub immediately because it changes my energy. But my favorite thing, besides this constellation bath curtain, is actually the nightclub situation that I have going on. So, watch. Bam! That was anticlimactic. This is why I don't go to nightclubs. Because who needs a nightclub when you can take a bath? If you have any questions on where I got certain things, please leave them in the comments below, and I will be more than happy to help you guys out and help you guys find these items. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. And I'll see you guys in my next video.